the site of a pre-conquest church stands Prospect House, which was opened as the offices of Eastern Counties newspapers in 1970. In 2002, the company became Archant and continues to publish the Eastern Daily Press and Norwich Evening News. The sculpture near the entrance is Public Sculpture by Bernard Meadows. Golden Ball Street. All Saints Church served as an Anglo-Catholic church until it was made redundant in 1973. The present building dates from the late 15th century, although it is thought there was a previous church on this site. The Victorians added the east window, and the top of the tower was added in 1913. Wesselgate Tower has recently been refurbished as residential apartments after many years of neglect. Number 20 Wesselgate, between the church and the tower, is a listed building dating from the late 16th, early 17th century. It was formerly the Light Horseman Public House, but from the mid-1800s has served as offices and restaurants. The Debenhams Building, which was formerly Curl's Department Store, opened in 1956, as the original Curl's Building was destroyed by bombs in the Second World War. The living wall was added to the side of the Marks & Spencer store in 2011 to attract bees, butterflies and other wildlife. St. Stephen's is a church with a variety of architectural styles, with sections of the building dating from between the middle of the 14th century to the early 1600s. Chantry Place Shopping Centre, which opened in 2005 as Chapelfield, was built on the site of the former Roundtree Macintosh chocolate factory. The site was first used by local firm Cayley's in 1890 for the production of mineral water from deep artesian wells. Brands such as Rollo, Kit Kat, Quality Street and Yorkie, amongst others, were produced at this site. Established on a site that was the field of St Mary's Chapel, part of a monastery that stood where the Theatre Royal now stands, Chapelfield Gardens were opened as a park in 1880 and are used for a number of events throughout the year, including the Norfolk and Norwich Festival. One of the longest stretches of the medieval city wall can be found along Chapelfield Road. J. Morry Smith was responsible for a number of pub signs for Morgan's Brewery, based in King Street. The impression of St. Stephen's Gate can be found on the side of the Coachmaker's Arms, south of the roundabout. St. Stephen Street was transformed by City Council and the Norwich Union in the early 1960s. There had been some bomb damage and the road was not wide enough for increased traffic flows. Older buildings were left on the west side, while the east side underwent a complete reconstruction. The Norwich Union had been formed in 1797 by Thomas Bignald as an insurer against fire. A life assurance business was started in 1808, and a century earlier in 1706, the Right Reverend William Talbot had been an initial supporter of the Amicable Society, which eventually amalgamated with the Union in 1866. As the firm expanded, more offices filled the triangle of land bordered by Wesselgate, Surrey Street and St Stephen Street. Surrey House was designed by George Skipper as the head office of the Norwich Union and opened in 1904. Norwich Bus Station was redeveloped in 2005 at a cost of £5 million. When it opened, it was one of the most advanced bus hubs in the country, facilities allowing for around 7,800 bus movements per week. The architecture of Thomas Ivory dominates the southern section of All Saints Green and its junction with Surrey Street. Ivory House on your left, St Catherine's on your right, former home to BBC East, and numbers 29 to 35 Surrey Street were all designed by him. Music. other dominant architecture of the area is that of the Norwich Union. Colin Miller's Gaia, Mother Earth, guards her children outside the Sentinel House. The new student flats, built on the site of the Carlton Gaumont Cinema, now loom large over the surrounding properties. The John Lewis store, still known by many locals as Bonds, was built in the late 1940s after the original Bonds had been destroyed by the Baedeker Raids of 1942. John Lewis took over the shop in 1982 and changed the name to John Lewis in 2001, when Monday opening was also introduced. The railings on the corner of Brook Place and Burr Street were created by the artist Chris Campbell. The bronze roundels attached to the railings depict old photographic images of St Michael at Thorn Church, which was demolished in 1952, and cattle on Burr Street in 1920. St Bartholomew's Church was abandoned in the 16th century. The building became surrounded by the industrialisation of the 18th and 19th century, and in 1939 the City Council began to clear the site to make it safe. The original use of many of Burr Street's buildings is hidden, including many pubs and this garage, which was once the depot for the Red Car Cullings Bus Company. St John de Sepulchre in Finglegate, the parish church of South Conisford, was made redundant in 1970 and after a period of use as an English Orthodox church is now once again redundant. Another J. Murray Smith pub sign can be seen on the former Morgan's Brewery pub at the end of Burr Street. The section of walls in the Carrow Hill area form the most complete section of defensive wall that remain in the city. Standing at around 11 metres tall, the Black Tower has had a number of uses over the years, including a prison and plague house. The Wilderness Wall, which includes a further tower, connected with the Conisford Gate on King Street, and together with the Black Tower, this defensive section of wall would have provided an imposing site for potential attackers approaching the city from the south. At the bottom of the hill, continue to the right of the wall, down to the river, and Paper Mill Yard, part of the Coleman's Mustard Works. Also the boom towers can be seen. These used a chain across the water between the two towers to control river traffic and prevent unauthorised entry of vehicles. The Albion Mill complex was built in the 1830s as a textile mill, and in the late 19th century it became Cooper's Biscuit Factory. From 1932 until the 1990s, it was used by R.J. Reed for flour milling. The building was converted to flats and apartments, and it has become one of the most expensive blocks in the city. The remains of St. Peter, Southgate, can be found in a small sloping open space overlooking the Wensum Valley. As the area of Lakenham, outside the city walls, expanded, the Victorians abandoned St. Peter's and built the Church of St. Mark's. Most of St. Peter's was demolished in 1880, just leaving the base of the tower. St. Etheldreda's contains a mix of building styles, from early Norman to later Victorian. The tower has a round base with an octagonal belfry, which was added in 1723. It was made redundant in 1975, and is currently used by a group of artists as affordable studio space. St. Julian's is one of Norwich's most famous churches, as it stands on the site where Dame Julian of Norwich, the 14th century theologian and writer, lived. The original building was destroyed by German bombs, and the current building, built to a very similar design, dates from 1953.